Would you like the ability to be able to pipe in any video that you want within the output that goes in your Zoom screen? If you're on a Zoom meeting and normally it just shows you on camera, would you like to be able to place a link right here on the page? Would you like to be able to place a piece of text here and move it up to the top and change it to be, if I can change the color, if we can make it a yellow color, and if you could place your web address right there, and if we can make it a different font size, resize that and put that right here. Wouldn't you love to be able to just put this right here on what people see for your Zoom video? Wouldn't you love to be able to share your desktop screen? Now, Zoom itself allows you to share your screen kind of off to the side, but when you're seeing many of the people, wouldn't you like to be one of these people that didn't even have to ask for permission, and you could just call up and you could show whatever browser window or desktop screen that you wanted to play? Or wouldn't you want to be able to change and show some other different camera, or even play a video back over Zoom? Well, let me show you how to do that. And here's the secret. The way that you do this is using a tool called OBS Studio and using OBS Studio's virtual camera. And so I've used this as a podcast guest, where if I'm speaking or something on someone else's show, we're recording on Zoom. If I just want to switch to my desktop as a host, if someone is demonstrating their website, I just kind of switch over to the desktop, and I might even click a button and hide myself, and just they're over on their window and I'm here on my window just showing my desktop screen. So you can do all this and more and just pipe anything in to your Zoom output. And it's really simple and really easy once you know how. So let me show you how we do this. We'll start by doing a Google search for OBS Studio. We end up going to obsproject.com. This is completely free. You choose the version. I'm a Windows user, so we'll choose that. Now it's downloading, and we will download the installer file. You run through the installation process, and then it will install this program here, coming up in a moment, called OBS Studio. And right here, there's nothing much you can do. There's just this scene here. What we can do right here is just click on where there's scenes, click on this plus sign, and then I like to call this me. So here's the me scene. I'll delete this default one. And so you can set up these scenes, and you can have multiple ones on this left side here. And if you want to switch between showing your web camera or showing your desktop or playing back a video or things like that, you can switch those. And then once you choose what your video output will be, you can then stream using this to Facebook Live or to YouTube Live. You can just click on this simple start recording button, and it will record an MP4 video for you. Or here's where we can start the virtual camera and push the video through Zoom. So we've created this me scene, and then our scenes contain sources. And so for this me scene, we want to look at our web camera. So we click on this plus sign here, and then they call a web camera a video capture device. And so what I do is usually I will set up this web camera, this video capture device, and then I might add text on top. And then you could even add, say, like an image or a graphic as part of your text. So we click on this video capture device, and then we'll just say web camera, and I think this is my 4K web camera. So we name it what we want, and then it says, well, which device? And then we can switch through here, and I believe that I have two web cameras set up. I have one over on the side there, but the one I really want to switch to is this Logitech Brio. So here we are. Now here we are on camera. And you might notice something. You might notice, let us do this correctly. If I click on OK, then can we choose like this frame rate and everything? So I like to set a resolution. Let's see what it lets me set this as. Highest frame rate. Is that too big? Is that too much? And so you can get really fancy and technical as far as your video settings. But see what happened is I created my video and I have all this extra space, right? It's almost like being on a movie set and you see all the things that are outside. So you can resize this and make this larger or smaller. And I have a green screen back here behind me. And so I can just move this the way I want and get myself looking at the camera. And then I can go to these edges and hold down the Alt key and then kind of trim my video here and make it fit that the way I want, right? So I kind of have a smaller video here, but I can also resize it and take up all the space. And I say, oh, I don't like how there's that on the bottom there. And I can Alt and hold this down. And now, see, it's just me on video and I can maybe enlarge it and get it to fit just right. And now here's a little quick bonus we'll throw in is I have a solid color behind me, right? A solid green screen. And what we can do is actually do a green screen in real time or either capture it as is with the green or put in whatever background that we want. So I can go to settings here and I want to make sure that we have this one box checked here, which says something about like hide or show OBS. Yeah, so this hide OBS windows from screen capture. Want to make sure that's not checked, okay, because that'll be useful in a moment. And then I go to this web camera I've created and right-click it and go to, I thought there was like a filters. Maybe I need to be in a larger window. Let me move this over. Maybe my screen is too small. Okay, it is. So if I right-click and can even get down to it, can't get down to that, okay. So if I right-click and go, there's a filters way down there. So I right-click that, sources, choose filters, and then here's what we can set. I mean, there's all kinds of crazy stuff you could do, right? You could add, adjust the color and things like that. And what we want to do is click on this plus sign and then do a chroma key filter. So this is what they call a green screen, so chroma key. And then what we can do here is key color type, custom color, select color, and here's the most important part, pick screen color. This really delayed me for so long trying to figure this one out. So we just are setting up our chroma key, select color, pick screen color. Whoops, I need to move this over a little bit. And also let me undo the eyeball because you see it kind of sort of tried to blacken out that green behind us, but not the exact shade of green. So we undo the eyeball, select color, pick screen color, and then we can just kind of hover over our cells here and maybe see what's that say, 6A, 7A, just kind of try to get something that's close. And then re-enable it. And then we can slide around and be really careful with this similarity. And if you can't see yourself in that really tiny screen there, then you could look at in your, you can kind of move this over and see yourself on the bigger screen and then just adjust these. And so I think that for similarity, you really don't need to go more than like 25 or so. And then you just kind of get this until you sort of look okay. And so you don't look too fuzzy around the edges. But if you do this too much, you disappear or you lose some of the color in yourself. So we can now just kind of adjust that. I'm never really super happy with it. But anyway, we can get that set up and then click on close. And check this out. Now I am in a black void instead of the screen behind me. And then we can go and do another plus sign and add an image. And then we will just call this background. And then you can add in, now this part's on you, to get yourself an interesting background. But like you can add like the beach. And then we see how these are in order. You drag that down and check it out. Now I'm in a beach resort And this is the background behind me. And then I can go and add a text layer. And then maybe we'll just say name. And then I can just type in maybe my name, Robert Plank, and I can set the font and I can set the color and things like that and just position this. So, for example, imagine if you were on a Zoom call and just had your name right there on the bottom. That could be interesting. And then we could go and click on this plus sign again and then choose a scene called desktop. Then under sources here, we choose display capture. This will capture an entire screen of ours, and we'll say monitor maybe. And then display, we can just choose which of our desktop screens that we want, and then we can just position that in the size we want. So now we can switch between me being here or me being on the desktop, and hey, we can also go to these sources and also click the plus sign and add the video capture again. But instead of a new one, we add that web camera we added previously, and here I am, and I can just shrink myself and do that little alt and trim the edges again. And I can just position myself anywhere. And is that desktop? Okay, it's showing the whole desktop. And I can put myself on the left or on the right, but now I just kind of live here within, maybe if I want to give myself a little more room for, oh, see, there goes the green screen. There's the edge of the green screen. Now I can kind of live here within the little space that I'm in. So we can switch either between me or the desktop. And then now it's just a good time to go to these buttons. So we can just click on start recording, and then here's me talking and here's me on the web camera. So imagine if you were going to make some kind of a quick video of you looking right at the camera. You can just go and click on start recording. And one other thing I think we need to do, we need to set the microphone, because I'm recording this and I'm realizing that nothing is coming out on as I'm speaking. So we can go to our settings and then audio, and then the mic auxiliary audio, we'll just choose and you can play around and see which one it allows you to use. And now see when I'm speaking, now we have an audio. So now when I click on start recording and I talk and talk, here I am, and you can hear me, click stop recording. And then on the bottom here, it gives you this, so see on the very bottom left corner, it tells you where it saved the video. And for me, this is a videos folder, and it just kind of auto names it. And I can double click on this.
Start recording, and I talk and talk.
Here we go, and I can
here
see.
Here I am.
You can see the main my green screen click. Needs a little bit more adjusting, but you get
start
the idea
recording.
That you can just click and then have a recording of yourself just that quickly and just that easily. Okay, so that's as far as recording. And then the virtual camera is even easier. So for virtual camera, we will go to zoom.us. Now, unless you've been living under a rock for the past several years, Zoom is a video conferencing tool that allows you to just meet with anyone via video chat. And all you have to do is literally just say host with video on. You click on that, and if you need to make a Zoom account, it is free to create a session up to 45 minutes. So we've logged in, and all we have to do is say host with video on, and it will fire up this Zoom meeting for us. And it says meeting is being recorded, so got it. And I can just stop the recording. So I want to stop. And then with Zoom here, you choose your microphone, you choose your video. We can switch over, and I think here's my video camera, which I believe Zoom or OBS is using. So if I click on start video, well, it might be using it, so 1 second. I think I'm actually, I'm going to shut OBS completely off for a moment. So I'll start video. Here we go. So here you're on video. This is just going right here through Zoom and sure, Zoom does have a backgrounds functionality, but it's still just not quite the same as being able to, like, if I want to cut off the top and I want to set my background and put text, all that is accomplished through OBS. Now, how the heck is that done? Glad you asked. You go over here in Zoom where you started and stopped your video, and you can choose your video, and here's your normal web camera, but OBS adds this OBS virtual camera. You click on that, and now, oh no, where did I go? What's this weird symbol? Well, this, whenever you fire up OBS and you click on that virtual camera button, it will just pipe that video through here through Zoom. So if we start OBS back up, so here we are back as we were, and oh yeah, I do kind of tell I am sort of fuzzy, so maybe you go and adjust your filters a little bit, and we say I will make my similarity a little less. And I guess we like that. So here we are in OBS, and we just literally just click Start Virtual Camera, and I'll even have Zoom back behind here. So we click on Start Virtual Camera, then just like that, literally one click. Now see if you can tell this is like the Zoom area here. Now what I'm putting through OBS is what appears over in my Zoom window. And if I switch in OBS to my desktop, whoa, well, that's kind of psychedelic, but maybe I need to switch to my other screen then. So if I say monitor, if I switch to the other one, did that even, what's it showing? So if that's the web camera and now the monitor, that's getting sort of psychedelic. Okay, oh, there we go, that's better. So now we can just show our monitor and I can just be in here. But again, this might get a little weird and crazy, but this is within Zoom. You can see there's like the end button here, right? We're right here within Zoom. So let me switch this back to the screen that I wanted. And now we're back here. And one final thing is, if you are in control of the Zoom meeting, there is this speaker and gallery choice, right? And so speaker view means that if you have two people talking, say in a Zoom interview, it just shows just the person talking. And then if you talk, it shows just you. And then the gallery setting is where it shows both of you side by side. And so you can take that into account if you want to decide for your recording who you want to show. And now you can kind of basically have unlimited freedom, right? Because if you want to record just your side of things, if you want to have like a high quality backup recording of, say, your Zoom presentation, you can just click on Start Recording and have your side of the conversation, including your audio, off in its own video file. But then at any time, you can start or stop the virtual camera, and that will put through anything from OBS, including things like the background or including things like any text that you put right there in front of Zoom using the OBS virtual camera. And in Zoom, switching your camera source from your usual webcam to the OBS virtual camera. So it's exciting times to be alive, to be Zooming, and to be able to have complete control of what video you put through your Zoom connection, whether you're doing like a meeting, a webinar, a podcast, whatever. OBS virtual camera plus Zoom, you can accomplish amazing things.